How can small motors start a large wind turbine? Without reducer. The lift-type vertical axis wind turbine is difficult to start by itself, but it can achieve high efficiency after assisted starting. Traditionally, drag-type blades are used to assist starting. But when the wind turbine is larger in size, drag blades are not suitable. Due to the wide and thin structure of the drag blade, it is difficult to maintain the required strength when enlarged, so the large vertical axis wind turbine is usually started by a motor. There is also a variable pitch method to start, which will not be discussed here due to the complex structure. When the size of the wind turbine is large, the starter motor is also large, usually with a reducer to amplify the torque to drive the wind turbine. In addition, a high power driver is also required, so it is not only costly but also prone to failure. If you directly drive a motor with a large number of poles to abandon the reducer, the cost is still very high. This video shows a completely new approach. Using the Magnus effect to start a lift-type vertical axis wind turbine. Since only driving the cylindrical rotor, rather than the entire wind turbine, a few small motors are sufficient. This eliminates the need for a large starter motor, reducer and driver, making it cost-effective and reliable. When the rotor rotates in the wind turbine is drived to rotate through the Magnus effect, and when the rotation speed is fast enough, it can be used to generate electricity. Then make the experimental device. Start testing. The rotation radius of the rotor is set to 2/3 of the wind turbine. The acceleration is quite fast. After a while, the maximum speed can only reach about 60 rpm and cannot be increased anymore, must be adjusted. The rotation radius of the rotor is reduced to 1/4 of the wind turbine, with the hope that the rotation speed can exceed 100 rpm. As the radius gets smaller, so does the torque. Acceleration is also slower. However, the speed of the motor has not been pushed to the limit so that there is still room for improvement. Continuing to accelerate. After a while, the wind turbine speed reaches 60 rpm. At this time, turn off the motor to stop rotation of the rotor. Will this wind turbine stop? The wind turbine did not slow down, instead, it continued to accelerate. Because the lift blade comes into play at the current speed, the wind turbine is not connected to an external motor. 100 revolutions per minute. Above 110 rpm, the wind turbine has started to reach the working speed. From this experiment, we can see that by making good use of the Magnus effect, small motors can drive a large wind turbine. When the wind turbine rotates fast enough, the rotor motor can stop and no more energy is consumed. Compared with direct starting with the motor, the high power motor, reducer and driver are omitted, so the cost is greatly reduced. This might be an easy and cheap way to start a large lift-type vertical axis wind turbine.